Hello and welcome to the last part of physics chapter 1 motion. And before we begin, kuch doubts puche mujhe exercise 1 e mein se. Let's discuss those doubts and then move ahead, finish the chapter. Last part is very small, very tiny. We'll finish it soon, and then you have a huge homework coming up. So you must be wondering, itna time lag gaya first chapter karne mein, pata nahi dusre chapter kitne bade honge. सो फिजिक्स में प्लीज रिमेंबर वन थिंग, ये फर्स्ट चैप्टर जो है ना, इट कंटेन सो मच ऑफ बेसिक आइडियाज, बेसिक फंडामेंटल्स, कॉन्सेप्ट्स विच मस्ट बी स्टडीड इन डिटेल. एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई मेड मोर देन 5 to 6 वीडियोज. मे बी दिस इज माई 6th or 7th वीडियो फॉर द चैप्टर. तुम सोच रहे होगे कि स्कूल में तो ये जल्दी खत्म कर दिया था, इतना कुछ पढ़ाया भी नहीं. सो ऐसा ही होता है, बिकॉज दे हैव अ ड्यूटी टू डू. They are doing their job, and I have a separate kind of responsibility which I feel towards all of you. So I will teach each and every topic in detail so that you don't miss out on any small thing. And you know, you will understand, you are already understanding even after teaching in so much detail. It is not easy to score marks in exam, in test, my tests. So yes, it requires this much of detail, and I'm glad that I'm able to do in this much of detail, and I'm not in any race with any school syllabus or anything. So my idea is to clear your concept anyhow. Let's clear the doubts first. First doubt asked by some student: derive the equation of motion by two different methods. So beta, isme you have to derive the three equations of motion, that is v is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, and v square minus u square is equal to 2as. These three equations of motion must be derived by you in this question by both methods. Two different methods means both methods, that is graphical method as well as algebraic method, right? The methods which I have taught you in detail in last previous video. So if you have doubt, go and watch the previous video all over again, and without copying, please derive these two equations graphically and algebraically for the first question. And that's it. I can't help you anything else for this question. Fourth question: the brakes are applied to a car. Just a moment, let me make it small so that, yes, now we can see. So fourth question, let me make some space here. Okay, brakes are applied to a car to produce an acceleration of 6 m/s² in opposite direction to the motion. So the acceleration is -6 m/s² because whenever brakes are applied, the speed of the car decreases. So acceleration is always negative. Opposite direction also means acceleration is negative. If the car takes 2 seconds to stop, so final velocity of car is 0 m/s, and time taken by the car to stop is 2 seconds. Calculate the distance it travels during this time. S, we have to find S. So S is equal to ut plus half at square, but we don't have u. Then v square minus u square is equal to 2as. Again, we don't have u. So anyhow, we have to find u for finding S. So I'll use the first equation. V is equal to u plus at. What is v? 0. What is u? Don't know. What is a? -6. And what is time? 2. So 0 is equal to u minus 12. So initial velocity is 12 m/s. We got u. Now we can find s. S is equal to ut plus half at square. S is equal to ut plus half at square. Now what is s? In this case, we don't know s. What is U? 12. What is T? 2. Plus what is acceleration? Minus 6. And what is time square? 2 square. Right? Let's find out. 24 plus half. Okay, I'll cut this here. This will become minus 3. So we can get a simplified answer before that. And this will be minus 3 into 4. So S is equal to 24 minus 12. That is 12 meter. So that is the answer of fourth question. Somebody had doubt in the fourth question. Please check this method. Yeah. Let's go to the next question. Fifth question. A lot of things are asked in the fifth question. Let me make it smaller. Okay, so what is the fifth question? Let me move it up over here. Cool. Okay, so fifth question. A car moving along a straight line. Can you see the fifth question over here? A car moving along a straight line at a speed of 72 km per hour. So initial velocity is 72 km per hour. Now this can be converted into meter per second. So 72 multiplied by 5 by 18 meter per second. Right? 18 fours are 72. And this initial velocity becomes 20 meter per second. So a car moving along a straight line at a speed of 72 km per hour stops in 5 seconds. How much time does it take? 5 seconds to stop after the brakes are applied. Okay, so final velocity is 0 meter per second. Find the acceleration. Very easy. We have to find the acceleration, for which we will use the equation of motion. V is equal to u plus at. Correct? So what is v? V is equal to 0, u is 20, a we don't know, and t is 5. So minus 20 is equal to 5a, a is equal to minus 4 meter per second square. It is natural for a to come negative because a moving car is brakes are applied on a moving car. So its velocity will decrease with time. Plot the graph of speed versus time. So here we have to plot speed versus time graph. See, for plotting speed versus time graph, always remember that speed will come on y-axis and time will come on x-axis. Now its initial speed was how much? 20 meter per second. So suppose this is 20 and final speed was 0, and after in how much second this happens? 5 seconds. So this is 0 second, this is 5 seconds, and that is the graph. This is the graph, speed time graph. This is the initial velocity, final velocity is 0. This is initial time, final time. Correct? Speed time graph. This is how it will look like. Using the graph, find the distance covered by the car after the brakes are applied. Okay, so now we have to find the distance covered. So distance covered can be found out by finding the area under the graph of VT graph. So distance covered is equal to area of this right angle triangle, that is half into base is 5 into height is 20. That is 2 tens are, and the answer should be 50 meter. So that is from the graph. Okay. Now we'll again find the distance using equations of motion. So which equation of motion we'll use? We can use S is equal to ut plus half at square. We can use that. So let's use and verify whether this answer is correct or not. So S is equal to ut plus half at square. So S is equal to u, that is 20 meter per second, multiplied by t plus half into minus 4 into t square, that is 5 square. So 100 plus, this will get cut, minus 2 into 5 square into 25. So s is equal to 100 minus 50, which is 50 meter, right? We got the same answer using the equation of motion which we got from the graph. So that means whether you solve any situation graphically or algebraically with equations of motion, you will get, you must get, and you should get the same answer, right? So the next question was fifth question, which was solved. Now sixth question is also doubt. Somebody asked me this: an object is dropped from a height of 120 meter. Okay, so let's take it to an empty space over here. Okay, an object is dropped from a height of 120 meter. Okay, so the height is 120 meter. Dropped. Whenever any object is dropped, its initial velocity is 0 meter per second. Remember that. The acceleration of the object is 10 meter per second square downward. Now the object is going down and it is increasing its speed while falling. It is increasing its speed while falling by 10 meter per second every second. So the acceleration, this is a special acceleration known as acceleration due to gravity. Okay, we will study about this in chapter 3. So acceleration is 10 meter per second square. Is it positive or negative? Of course positive, because whenever any object falls down, its speed goes on increasing. So it is positive acceleration. Find the distance by the object after 1 second, 2 second and 3 second. What is the final velocity of the object after 3 seconds? Very good. So you have to find S1, S2 and S3. Right? And we also have to find V3. This is easy, quite easy. Okay, so here remember, the height is nothing but the distance, total distance to be covered. Okay, distance traveled by the object after 1 second is the height by which the object is falling after 1 second. We can find that out, but for that we need s is equal to ut plus half at square. We don't need anything actually. We have s1 is the distance traveled by the object after 1 second, so we know the time also. S is equal to ut plus half at square. Okay, so u, what is u? 0. What is time? 1, because we have to find the distance traveled by the object after 1 second. Plus half multiplied by a is 10, multiplied by t square, which is 1 square. So this will get cut and this will be 5. 1 into 0 is 0 plus 5 is 5 meter. So distance traveled after 1 second is 5 meter. Okay, let's find the distance traveled after 2 seconds. Again ut plus half at square. Okay, so this will become 0 multiplied by 2 plus half into 10 into 2 square. So this 2 will get cut with this 2 and it will become 20 meter. So after 2 seconds, the object will cover 20 meter. Let's find out S3. Again, ut plus half at square, which is u is 0 initial velocity. Time is 3 seconds plus half into 10 into 3 square. Correct? So this will become 90 by 2, which is 45 meter. So the body will cover 5 meter after 1 second, 20 meter after 2 seconds, and 45 meter after 2 seconds. In the first second, the body is covering 5 meter. In the second second, the body is covering 15 meter. In the third second, the body is covering 25 meter. The body is covering unequal distances in equal intervals of time. So this is non-uniform motion. And remember, all freely falling objects, they exhibit non-uniform motion. because their motion is accelerated, right? So we found all the three distances after 1, 2, and 3 seconds. Now we have to find the velocity at the end of 3 seconds. So very simple, we can use the equation v square minus u square is equal to 2as. Now we have to find the velocity at the end of 3 seconds, right? So we'll take the distance also at the end of 3 seconds only, right? Chalo, v3 the whole square minus what is u, 0 square is equal to 2 multiplied by a, which is acceleration, which is 10, multiplied by s3, which is 45. Okay, so v3 square is equal to 20 into 45, which is 900. So v3 is equal to square root of 900, which is equal to 30 meter per second. So the speed of the body after 3 seconds will become 30 meter per second. It is also obvious because the speed of acceleration of the body is 10 meter per second square. That means the speed of the body is increasing by 10 meter per second every second. So the body is traveling at 0 meter per second. See, at 0 second the speed is 0 meter per second. At 1 second the speed is 10 meter per second. At 2 second the speed is 20 meter per second. Every second the speed is increasing by 10 meter per second. That's why the acceleration is 10 meter per second square. After 3 second the speed is 30 meter per second. Can you tell me what will be the speed after 4 seconds? 40 meter. Every second speed will increase by 10 meter per second. That is what the meaning is. So this answer was inevitable. It was obvious, right? So all the doubts are cleared. Seventh question, somebody had doubt. I don't know if they asked me the seventh question. Did I do 4, 5, 6? Seventh also, I think somebody asked me. Let's do it. Otherwise, that poor fellow will feel that I am not solving their doubts. Although I am in full, you can say, oops, I'm sorry. What is this? Okay. Yes, so let's solve the seventh question now. Hey, 1 second. Correct. An object moving with a velocity of +6 meter per second. Let's try to understand this. An object moving with a velocity of +6 meter per second. Moving with a velocity. Okay. So initial velocity is +6 meter per second. And with an acceleration of -1 meter per second square. No problem. That means its speed is decreasing. What will be the distance traveled by the car or the object before coming to rest? So what will be the distance before coming to rest? That is, final velocity is 0 meter per second. Okay, so we can use v square minus u square is equal to 2as to find the displacement. That is what the third equation relates with. It relates u, a, s and v. So what is v? 0. 0 square minus 6 square is equal to 2 multiplied by minus 1 multiplied by s. So 36, I'm sorry, minus 36. So minus 0 square minus 0 minus 36 is minus 36 is equal to minus 2s. Therefore, s is equal to 18 meter. Easy. Distance traveled by the car before coming to rest is 18 meter. Time taken for coming to rest. time taken for coming to rest. It's also easy. V is equal to u plus at. What is v? 0. What is u? 6. What is a? Minus 1. What is t? We don't know. So 0 is equal to 6 minus t. So t is equal to 6 seconds. So it will come to rest in 6 seconds. Correct? Very easy questions, right? You feel that they are easy or not? They are easy. Only thing, you need to think differently. Next topic, we are ready with the next topic. Uniform circular motion, last topic of the chapter. Are you happy the chapter is at its end? So what is uniform circular motion? When a particle moves in a circular path with constant speed, its motion is called uniform circular motion. Let's take an example. So okay, so here there is sun and there is a planet over here, let's say Earth. So what is happening? Earth is moving in this circular path around the sun with constant speed. Why? How we can say that Earth is moving with constant speed? Because every time, since millions of years, every time when the Earth completes one revolution around the sun, it takes fixed time, that is 365 days approximately, fixed time. So if the distance is same, distance is of course same, the orbit does not become bigger or smaller. It stays the same, more or less. Right? And the time remains same. Then the speed of the object moving in circular path will always be same. Right? That means Earth is moving around Sun with constant speed. That is, it covers equal distances in equal intervals of time. What is the interval of time? 1 year. And what is the distance? Circumference of the orbit. So Earth is moving around the sun in a circular path with constant speed. That is, it covers equal distances in equal intervals of time. Therefore, Earth is said to be moving with uniform circular motion. Earth is said to be moving with uniform circular motion. That is just a single, one small example of uniform circular motion. There can be 100 other examples, but this is because we all know, so we cannot relate with this example. So here they have described this motion in detail. Since direction of motion changes in uniform circular motion, it is a case of accelerated motion. Please note this. So if the object is here and it is moving in circular path, actually it should have gone straight, but it is moving in circular path. So its direction changes when it turns and then it reaches point B. Again, it should go straight, but it does not go straight. It turns. Always the body turns and changes its direction. So whenever the body is moving with uniform speed, but not in the same direction, if the direction of motion continuously changes, which is the case in circular motion, then that kind of motion is also known as accelerated motion. So we can say one very important point we can make here, that uniform circular motion uniform circular motion is an example of accelerated motion. Uniform circular motion is an example of accelerated motion. Why accelerated? Due to constant speed? No, due to change in direction. Since in circular path the direction of motion is always changing, hence it is an example of accelerated motion. So here they have given you an example of that constant speed. The formula 2 pi r by t. What is 2 pi r? 2 pi r is the circumference of the circle. That is the distance traveled by the object moving in circular path, and t is time. So distance upon time is speed. 2 pi r upon t is the speed of a body moving in circular path. एग्जाम्पल्स देखो, एक पहला एग्जाम्पल है आर्टिफिशियल सैटेलाइट सर्कलिंग ऑर्बिटिंग अराउंड अर्थ, राइट? अब व्हाट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर मेकिंग दिस आर्टिफिशियल सैटेलाइट मूव अराउंड अर्थ? द सेम फोर्स विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर मूविंग द प्लैनेट अराउंड सन. एक प्लैनेट को सन के अराउंड कौन ऑर्बिट करने के लिए पुल करता रहता है? तो एक फोर्स है जो प्लैनेट के सेंटर से सन के सेंटर पे एक्ट करता है, जिसको क्या बोलते हैं पता है तुम्हें? ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स. ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स. तो ये ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स की वजह से सन अर्थ की तरफ अट्रैक्टेड रहता है, लेकिन सन को भी अर्थ अट्रैक्ट करता है. तो ऐसा नहीं है कि सन में जाके गिर जाएगा. नहीं गिर सकता, क्योंकि ये फोर्स टू साइडेड है. सन की तरफ से अर्थ को और अर्थ की तरफ से सन को, दोनों की तरफ अट्रैक्टेड फोर्स है, अट्रैक्टिव फोर्स है, जिसको ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स बोलते हैं. क्योंकि सन बड़ा है इसलिए सन के अराउंड अर्थ घूमता रहता है. वैसे क्योंकि अर्थ बड़ा है तो अर्थ के अराउंड आर्टिफिशियल सैटेलाइट घूमते रहते हैं ड्यू टू ये ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स. और ये ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स का डायरेक्शन सेंटर के तरफ है, सन के सेंटर की तरफ या ऑर्बिट के सेंटर की तरफ. इसलिए इसको एक स्पेशल नाम दिया है, सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स. सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स मतलब किसी भी ऑब्जेक्ट को सर्कुलर पाथ में मूव करने के लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल फोर्स कौन सा होता है? विच फोर्स इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर मूविंग एनी ऑब्जेक्ट इन अ सर्कुलर पाथ? सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स. सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स. इन द केस ऑफ सन एंड अर्थ द सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स इज ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स. लेकिन हमें, मैं तुम्हें दूसरा एग्जांपल देता हूं. सपोज एक इसको थोड़ा सा करेक्ट कर लेते हैं, हम लोग पूरा इरेज हो जाता है. ठीक है, मैंने एक रस्सी से एक स्टोन को बांधा हुआ है यहां पे, और वो स्टोन को मैं ऐसे घुमा रहा हूं. ठीक है, स्टोन को मैं घुमा रहा हूं ऐसे. अब जब वो स्टोन घूमता रहेगा उसके ऊपर कौन सा फोर्स है? ऐसा लगता है कि कोई स्टोन को सेंटर की तरफ खींच रहा है, मतलब स्टोन सेंटर की तरफ अट्रैक्टेड है. ठीक है, और उसके अगेंस्ट में सेंटर से स्टोन की तरफ भी एक फोर्स जा रहा है. जो स्ट्रिंग है जो हमने बांधा है स्टोन को, वो ऐसा खींच जाता है, उसमें टेंशन क्रिएट होता है. क्या क्रिएट होता है? टेंशन. टेंशन मतलब खिंचाव, स्ट्रिंग खिंच जाता है. तो जैसे अर्थ और सन के बीच में ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स का काम कर रहा था, वैसे ही स्टोन और ये सेंटर हमारे हाथ के बीच में फोर्स ऑफ टेंशन, खिंचाव का फोर्स काम करता है. किसका? सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स का. मतलब कौन ये स्टोन को सर्कुलर पाथ में घूमने के लिए फोर्स कर रहा है? फोर्स ऑफ टेंशन. और ये फोर्स ऑफ टेंशन को हम लोग सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स भी बोल सकते हैं. ठीक है, मतलब किसी भी ऑब्जेक्ट को अगर सर्कुलर पाथ में घूमना है तो उसके ऊपर एक सेंटर की तरफ से फोर्स होना चाहिए, जिसको बोलते हैं सेंट्रीपेटल फोर्स. अच्छा, एक साइक्लिस्ट जब सर्कुलर ट्रैक पे चलता है कॉन्स्टेंट स्पीड के साथ, तो उसको भी हम लोग बोलते हैं कि वो एक एग्जाम्पल है यूनिफॉर्म सर्कुलर मोशन का. उसका एक्सेलरेशन जीरो है मैग्नीट्यूड में, लेकिन क्योंकि उसका डायरेक्शन चेंज होता रहता है इसलिए उसको एक्सेलरेटेड मोशन हम बोल सकते हैं. लेट्स टेक वन मोर एग्जाम्पल, नॉट वन मोर एग्जाम्पल, द फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल. अ बॉडी मूव्स इन सर्कुलर पाथ ऑफ रेडियस 2 मीटर, इट कंप्लीट्स वन सर्कल इन 2 सेकेंड्स. एक सर्कल 2 सेकेंड में खत्म करता है. सर्कुलर पाथ की रेडियस है 1 मीटर, इसकी स्पीड ढूंढनी. तो स्पीड इज इक्वल टू 2 पाई आर अपॉन टी. सो 2 × 22/7 इंटू रेडियस कितनी है भाई, रेडियस है 1 मीटर, अपॉन टाइम कितना लगता है 2 सेकेंड्स. टाइम 2 ले लिया है, ठीक है. तो इसको हम लोग लिख सकते हैं 2 × 22/7 × 1. यहाँ पे 2 इधर आ जाएगा, 2 2 कैंसिल हो जाएगा, 22/7 या फिर 3.14 मीटर पर सेकेंड, ये उसकी स्पीड हो जाएगी, ठीक है, करेक्ट. चलो नोट कर लेना सब कुछ, नोट करना जो भी मैं दिखा रहा हूं तुम्हें. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, एन एथलीट कंप्लीट्स 1 राउंड ऑफ सर्कुलर ट्रैक ऑफ डायमीटर 100 मीटर. डायमीटर है 100 मीटर, तो रेडियस कितनी हो जाएगी 50 मीटर इन 15 सेकेंड्स. वॉट विल बी द डिस्टेंस कवर्ड एंड द डिस्प्लेसमेंट एट द एंड ऑफ 3 मिनट्स एंड 30 सेकेंड्स. अच्छा, बहुत अच्छा क्वेश्चन है. ओके, जरा ध्यान देना, मैं एक सर्कल बनाने वाला हूं. ऐसा गड़बड़िया सर्कल क्यों बन गया भाई? हटो यार. ओके, थोड़ा सा सर्कल हिला हुआ बना, मुझे नहीं पता क्या प्रॉब्लम है, ठीक है. तो एथलीट 1 राउंड लगाता है ये सर्कुलर ट्रैक का, जिसका डायमीटर है 100 मीटर, रेडियस 50 मीटर है, और 15 सेकेंड में 1 राउंड खत्म करता है. तो मतलब अगर वो ए से शुरू करता है, वापस ए पे आने के लिए उसको 15 सेकेंड लगते हैं. जस्ट इमेजिन, ए के एग्जैक्टली डायमेट्रिकली ऑपोजिट एक लाइन, मतलब एक पॉइंट है जिसको बोलते हैं पॉइंट बी, जस्ट डायमेट्रिकली ऑपोजिट, ठीक है. तो 15 सेकेंड में वो ए से वापस ए पे आता है, और उसका हमें डिस्टेंस और डिस्प्लेसमेंट निकालना है एट द एंड ऑफ 3 मीटर 3 मिनट्स एंड 30 सेकेंड्स. ओ, लेट्स डिवाइड दिस टाइम. सो टोटल टाइम, देखो हमने क्यों डिवाइड कर रहे हैं ये भी लिखना चाहिए. मैं तुम्हें आधी आधी चीजें बताऊंगा तो तुम्हें कभी नहीं समझेगा. ओके, नंबर ऑफ राउंड्स, कितने राउंड लगाए उसने घूमते हमने, टोटल टाइम अपॉन टाइम टेकन फॉर 1 राउंड. तो टोटल टाइम कितना है, 3 मीटर 3 मिनट्स 30 सेकेंड्स, 3 मिनट्स 30 सेकेंड्स. और 1 राउंड को कितना टाइम लगता है, 15 सेकेंड. पहले 3 मिनट 30 सेकेंड को सेकेंड में कन्वर्ट कर देते हैं, तो 3 मिनट कितना होता है, 3 मिनट्स इज इक्वल टू 3 × 60, दैट इज 180. 180 + 30 is 210 अपॉन 15. ओके, लेट्स डिवाइड दिस. सो 42 5s is 210, इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग. यस, 42 5s, 40 5s is 200 एंड 42 5s. सो 5 42s, 5 3s, and 3 14s. ग्रेट. सो वॉट हैपन्स आफ्टर 3 मिनट्स एंड 30 सेकेंड्स? आफ्टर 3 मिनट्स एंड 30 सेकेंड्स, दिस एथलीट हैज कंप्लीटेड 14 राउंड्स ऑफ दिस सर्कुलर पाथ. 14 राउंड्स, जस्ट इमेजिन. सो वॉट दे आर आस्किंग, वॉट विल बी द डिस्टेंस एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट. सी, आफ्टर 14 राउंड्स 1, 2, 3, 4, like that 14 rounds, he will again come back to point A. So displacement will definitely be 0, but we can find the distance. Okay, so distance is equal to circumference multiplied by 14. Circumference is 2 pi r multiplied by 14. So 2 into 22 by 7 into r is 50 into 14. 7 2s are 14, 50 2s are 100, 100 2s are 200 into 22. So 4400 meter. This is the distance. This is the distance. Displacement will be 0. Why displacement will be 0? Because displacement in a circular path, when a body comes back to its initial position, no matter how many rounds does it take, but if it comes back to its initial position, then the displacement will become 0. Let's check the answer. Correct, absolutely correct. And the displacement may be on the 0. Right? In the given figure, there are two arrows, blue and black. Okay, this is the black arrow, this is the blue arrow. Which color represents centripetal force and which one velocity? Okay, so the black arrow, all the black arrows are velocities. And the blue arrows are centripetal force. Very easy. Centripetal force is always directed towards the center. And velocity is always directed tangent to the circular path. You know what is a tangent? So this is a circle. If you draw a line, straight line, touching the circle at only one point, at any point you can draw such straight lines. And that straight line is known as tangent. Tangent always represents the direction of velocity. And if you draw a line which is towards the center, it always represents centripetal force. Correct. Name a motion in which object does not change its speed, but its direction of motion changes continuously. Circular motion. Calculate the velocity of tip of second hands of length 1.5 centimeter of a watch. Suppose there is a watch. Let's draw it. Okay. अरे जाओ यार नहीं जाओ कुछ हो गया. ओके सो द टिप ऑफ दिस वॉच इज सेकेंड्स हैंड विच इज 1.5 सेंटीमीटर ऑफ लेंथ. 1.5 सेंटीमीटर यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट इट्स वेलोसिटी. ओके नाउ टू कैलकुलेट इट्स वेलोसिटी वी शुड नो द डिस्टेंस कवर्ड बाय इट. सो डिस्टेंस covered by seconds hand is equal to 2 pi r. Correct? It covers a distance of 2 pi r. 2 multiplied by 22 upon 7 into 1.5. Right? So distance covered by seconds hand is 2 pi r. Why I have taken r as 1.5? Because the length serves as a radius. Length of seconds hand becomes the radius. So 1.5 into 2 is 3. 3 into 22 is 66 by 7 meter. 66 by 7 meter. This is the distance. And this distance, like full one rotation, in how much time does a second's hand make? It makes it in 1 minute. So the time is how much? 60 seconds. Right? So velocity is equal to distance. I'm sorry. Okay, so velocity is equal to distance upon time. distance is s. I'm sorry about that. And what is the distance? 66 by 7. And what is the time? 60 seconds. So this is, I'm sorry. So what, there is one mistake, one more mistake I've found. Let me just correct it. So here the distance which I've got is in centimeter, not meter, because the length of the seconds hand was given in centimeter. So this is in centimeter. To convert it into meter, I will divide it by 100. So it will become 66 by 700 meter. So 66 by 700, the whole upon 60. So it will become 66 upon 700 into 60. So this will be 6 tens. So 11 upon 7000, and this is in meter per second. We can also calculate it in centimeter per second, but let's find it out. 11 by 7000. Maybe let's see their answer. What is their answer? My answer is in meter per second. I can convert it into points also, but it will be very small. They have converted into points, so it will 0.01 meter per second. I'm sorry. So the same thing they have done, what I have done. Okay, so the chapter is over. The last exercise is very small, only 2 questions, but then there is NCERT exercise which I'm going to give you, right? So we have completed the first chapter of physics. Congratulations, successfully we have completed. But yes, the test is remaining, so I'm going to take test, but not now. So the next chapter which we are going to start after the completion of the homework of this part is chemistry, chapter 1, right? So see you in the next video. Bye bye.